Yeah.
Sure. Maybe, okay.
That's where I really, and simplified, so you don't go to jail.
Okay, so a couple of things on flat taxes. Every conversation about tax reform ends with some economist saying we should have flat tax rates, and the reason is because it's actually a good idea.
There we go.
I mean, you need to implement them in such a way that folks at the lower end of the income scale don't face the same tax rates as those at the higher end. And you have to be careful not to tax the basic consumption of poor people. It's actually not hard to design that. You can design a flat tax that kicks in at some higher point in the income scale, and that accomplishes the goals I mentioned. The problem is, and here Gail may have some input, the problem is it's I don't want to say it's a waste of time. I don't think it's time well spent for yet another conversation of tax reform to end on a suggestion that just ain't going to happen. It hasn't happened ever before. It's not going to happen probably in our lifetimes, I'm sorry to say. So I'm afraid that what we have to do in the real world is start to hammer away at some of the things that are infecting our tax code in ways that you and I can probably agree. So the fact that you pay 15% on what's called carried interest, the fact that you pay 15% if you're a hedge fund manager on capital gains from hedge funds that you don't even have any risk capital in, seems to me absurd. This is the Warren Buffett problem, but Mitt Romney recently surfaced with the same issue. Seems to me absurd when you've got other people paying on their wage income 35%, perhaps, I mean 36%, perhaps going up to 40. So it seems like we could agree on that.
I don't think we disagree on having everyone pay the same, but you got to include all forms of income. I mean, you really do have to include it there.
So this is a big form of agreement for the people right in the middle.
I think it is
there.
A great form of agreement, and you want to...